Arise, my India, was the clarion call used by Swami Vivekananda to awaken a nation. The Indian civilization remained intact for thousands of years because it relied on spiritual aspirations rather than on material gain. After independence, this spiritual focus was lost. We hope this series of talks, inspired by the teachings of Swami Vivekananda and Sri Ramakrishna, will reignite the spiritual flame of modern India.
Sri Jay Lakhani, an excellent communicator of Hinduism in Britain and director of the Hindu Academy, the Vivekananda Centre in London. Over the last 15 years, Sri Lakhani has given talks on Hinduism to thousands of youngsters at English schools, colleges and universities. If you wish to get a glimpse of the modern, dynamic face of Hinduism, then do not miss this series of talks.
Participating in the Hindu Academy celebration of Swami Vivekananda's birthday and the Hinduism Award ceremony. Swami Vivekananda stands for Comprehensive and Contemporary Vision of Hinduism. The Hindu Academy has used his vision of modern Hinduism to teach GCSE and advanced level Hinduism. We are pleased to report that in the last GCSE Hinduism exams, about half of our candidates obtained 100% marks. And that's good, a round of applause, definitely. And about 95% obtained A-star grades. So another round of applause. So we are here to celebrate their success. So let's begin our program. And we begin our program in a devotional mode through bhajans by Ashok Bhai and Girish Bhai.
Be
Have a dance item. So the two dancers are Devika and Gatri. Esha Mehta is going to play the Indian Rag Shiva on the clarinet.
Thank you. Well done, Esha.
Harrow Tamil and Fine Arts School. Please can I request the performers to come up front?
We're going to be performing Mr. Lalpur, and our guru is Sri Manitishan Jayanandan. The students are Sivani Sivadas, Shyamala Srikant, Kugapriya Kirupala Vetnam, Jatsani Sasi Karan, and Sophie Sridharan.
Next, we have the students of Bharata Lakshmi Balachandran, the Veena players. Thank you.
just a couple of words about the Limbai. Today, I am flying on his wings of inspiration, not having done anything but reaping the rewards. He is great, greater than I'm able to say, for carrying aloft the light of his great master, Swami Vivekananda. May he lead many youngsters and other ages from darkness into light through the force of spirituality and teaching Hinduism. May God grant him long life, continued energy, inspiration and health to continue in this divine task. That's all I have to say. Thank you.
Thank you for welcoming us so royally this afternoon, this evening. I come from a college with an ancient tradition. We're used to dressing up, but usually in black and white. So it's wonderful to see you in such wonderful colour, the dancing, the music, all tremendous. As a teacher and examiner myself, I first of all want to send my thanks to the teachers. Often get left out of all this. So congratulations to all the teachers on producing the most amazing results. I also know as an examiner that we don't give marks away lightly. And I want to re-emphasize to all of you that whatever marks you gained were done through hard work. They don't just happen overnight. So well done to the students as well. I'm putting a huge amount of effort in. And finally, I want to say something a little bit more serious, which is that education in your faith tradition is of enormous importance in the world at the moment. A lot of misunderstanding happens because people don't understand the faith in which they come from. That's all faiths. And one of the things that I do with Jay is to make sure that children of many different faith traditions are well educated so that they can defend their ideas and understand what they mean in a difficult world. So that's a serious point. But thank you all for making this evening such an enjoyable one.
Academy and how it started. It started by just a few girls learning about Hinduism. Then it spread. It started about 25 years ago. Then we started teaching GCSE Hinduism and then A-level Hinduism. And then we set up a lot of satellite classes throughout the country. You'll be surprised. Your classes, Birmingham, Leicester, Luton, Wellingborough, Slough, Reading, Croydon, Wimbledon, Ilford, Heston, Forest Hill, Shepherd's Bush, name it, we've been running classes all over the place. So it has really mushroomed into lots of, the reason why it's mushroomed is this, there were a lot of individuals, parents mainly, who took interest in running the classes themselves. And I'm very pleased we've got two people who come long way here, and I think you must acknowledge them. Can I ask them to stand up, Krishna Bhai and Ravi Bhai, please, can you stand up? I'm sure in the process I'll forget lots of names because we've got so many kind of well-wishers and helpers that we have within our group. Let me also say one other thing. There are two people who put me on the spot when they ask me challenging philosophic questions at tricky chaps. And one is this young man who was doing the Master of Ceremony today, Vijay Deolia. Can you give a round of applause? Training the questions, I said, Mr. Lakhani, you keep teaching us God is in yourself, it's your essential nature is God. We said, but I don't think I am God, I have forgotten. How can God forget? So how do you answer this chap? Tricky chap. Then you've got a very kind of even younger person. He's such a lovely man. He's been asking me such beautiful questions and such pointed questions. In the last question, last time we did some recording, he said, Dilipbhai, tell us, what is Maya? I said, leave me alone, leave me alone. Can I please ask Madan Bhai to stand up so you can give a round of applause to Madan Bhai, please. You see, we have generated a lot of interest, a lot of activities, and our presentation initially was just setting up GCS and Hinduism classes. It has spread wide now. We are re-exporting structured, sensible Hinduism back to India now, and it's being well received. We are getting 800 hits on our YouTube every night, 800 people looking at all the YouTubes. So this particular activity you set into motion has now come to fruition in a big way. Look, this can only happen because it's not the children only, but the parents who take interest in the education they want to pass on to their youngsters. If we forget to do that, the next generation is lost. Let me give one simple example, what we are trying to do at the moment. India, when it got independence, very foolishly decided to take Hinduism out of the curriculum of the education system. And that nation paid a heavy price. You can see today, the youngsters have link of the religion is purely superficial, artificial. So now we are telling the government of India, reintroduce Hinduism in the syllabus, in the curriculum of the education of that nation, otherwise you lost the plot. Look at this nation. Here, you can only teach one religion, you can teach five religions in every school. This is called mature secularism. It recognizes the role of religion for modern society. And we, supposed to be a spiritual nation, had forgotten about it. So this Hindu Academy is pushing the present government, prodding it, saying, put it back. We've got the template, we know what kind of questions should be asked. What is the comprehensive vision of Hinduism? We have the template. adopt it from us, we'll give it away to you. This is the, if you like, if we succeed, then the work of the Hindu Academy will have come to fruition. We are trying our best. Anyway, I must thank all of you for participating, for, you know, coming here to this wonderful kind of event, and I thank the special visitors, special guests. Thank you, my friends. Namaste.
Kashmir ke tan ka.